time.
Do it. Do it. I think that's amazing, amazing ability that we have in life, and we have to just appreciate what we've got in life, and every minute counts. We don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, and then we just learn. I've traveled by myself, and I do prefer travel by myself, meeting people on the way in the hostels. I usually stay in hostels, meeting people there, and then learning from others. That's that, you're just finding out about yourself, and then you just learn from, you know, yourself really, and then how to love yourself.
One eternity later.
I'm warning you.
Okay, I'm not shopping it.
Yow.
Yo, bite it.
Oh. Okay, what?
Oh, yeah, she bite half. Okay, she bite half.
Culture, Buddhism, I believe in the Buddhism, and people, I fall in love with the country, food, people, culture.
So, Kapon Temple is found in the reign of Pram Ma Kwang, the king of Lanark Temple. Basically, it has a lot of Buddhist relics itself. I think about 25 containers called Pra Op, including 357 Buddhist images.
Not bad, man.
Pretty. It was built on top of the old pagoda. This is actually a new one.
Thank you.
crocodile country have like a lot less respect for the people. They're like a lot worsely behaved, I'd say. Maybe just the culture and the way people are brought up. So in our where we're from, quite a lot of people have a lot of money. They're quite privileged, so not really taught respect when they're growing up, which is a big difference, like sort of an Asian culture where you always have to respect your elders and things like that.
Spot a little hottie when I flipped up the shade. Looking like a red rice sitting in the driveway. Bottle of Ciroc with her in the Kool-Aid. She done pulled up like I'm getting rid of waves. Are you tired from running through my mind? Take a break and we can have a good time. Show you moves like I'm the new James Brown. Me and you should get a room right now. Cause if it's gold, I'll throw it away. You're worth more than every single chain. It ain't gonna work if you don't want it to. Best drink I take is when I'm sipping you. You know where I go when we're dancing. Handshakes in the Hamptons and getting drunk in the mansions with you. And you look so
classy. 10 middle clip down. How high is it? Daddy, freaking me that.
Some people, there's a lot of pressure to like go work or go to another level of schooling. I think there's definitely the pressure to not travel, but some people like travel.
Single chain. Walk with a limp, it just means I'm cool. Next trip I take is just me and you. You know where I go when we're dancing. Handshakes in the Hamptons and getting drunk in the mansions with you.
Consumerism and popular culture has a role to play in it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, explain why. In what way?
I feel like consumerism is crazy and everyone comes here and just wants to spend all their money on little things they don't need, which I guess is good for the economy. But it's just like an unnecessary buying things you don't need. But that's like the definition of consumerism.
And I also think there's this like notion of going to like different parts of the world. It's like a very like common destination for people our age, because it's more like reachable as a destination. For better or for worse.
Any memorable events that would happen during your travels so far?
This way around or previous?
Previous.
The most I think was just before I finished my travel in November. I stayed over on the beach back in Phuket, and then I missed my bus. So the taxi to my to town was about 600 baht, which was the last money I had, and I didn't have that money left after the whole month traveling. So very kind shopkeeper from the bike shop, he gave me a ride for free. So I think that was very kind of him and very, very nice, and it shows what the culture is. And then we don't really get that on, you know, our side of the world.
What challenges have you faced during your travels?
I guess I travel alone sometimes. Sometimes it's a bit lonely, but when you are in hostels, you can talk to people, you can go out, so it's really the main part. Also, of course, the language, I don't speak Thai, so have fun.
I think mostly through talking to people. So like when you're meeting people, you're just like where are you going next? I can tell you stuff that you can do in certain places, and then you kind of work it around like that.
Every time when we see them, the first driver actually stopped by 7-Eleven right in the middle.
able to these kind of places in Malaysia, you'll feel kind of dirty. You can see sampah everywhere. But compared to in Chiang Mai, we rarely see like a single plastic bag on the floor. Or maybe tissue paper, none of it you can see that. And they feel easily clean up and dry. They didn't burn anything.
They don't burn their chopsticks.
Yeah,
they
don't want to call it. And it's very because of air pollution. So it's really amazing that they still they're really devoted, they still practice their...
Yeah, they give it but they didn't burn it.
Yeah, they offer it to their gods but they don't burn it.
Yeah.
And it's for environmental purposes, which is amazing. Mm. Oh, okay. Overall, this section. Actually, I would conclude this street as a very beautiful street. I think a lot of things change. I mean, our plans change a lot throughout this trip. We change our itinerary, we change a lot of things, even our accommodation. But what I experienced is, definitely, after sleeping four nights with this street, I got to know them more. And to travel into a foreign country, a far country where you're not home or where you have nobody to rely on, this is where you can really test your friendship. And actually, all four of us, I believe we have four different characters. And there's things that is very hard to bear with each other. But it's our last night, as I said. And we made it. It's actually an amazing thing. I consider this trip as a growth for me because I consider myself as a very quiet person, introvert, and I don't really write big gap. And for this trip, I have to travel with not that close friends, but actually have to be independent. Especially when we interviewed the backpackers, especially the last question was, what are your advices for being
you
friends
that travel outside your comfort zone?
Oh yeah, because I don't think I travel outside my comfort zone.
Yeah.
So this is my first time, and their advices are the same.
Just do it.
Go for it. There's nothing to lose, and I found that very true. And I'm trying to grow, to have a breakthrough in my life. Not because I care about how others see me. So in these 5 days, I was very insecure about myself. And what if they dislike me about this, about that? because we have different characters, and then we have to compromise. So I was scared that they would find me annoying or unbearable, but they didn't. And then things went well, and I'm very grateful that I had this experience to meet a lot of different people. So to conclude, actually it's a very wonderful trip. We are very thankful for everything because everything was just right. And the people we met, especially Thai people, was very friendly, very kind, they're willing to help. So yeah, so we got a good trip and hope you'll consider seeing me that happen. So yeah, thanks. Thank you, Mr. Ken.